Hi, my name is Sławomir. Welcome to my channel. Today I have a new project on the bench, a Russian Vostok Amphibia, a watch that at the moment is not working. The Vostok Amphibia has a fascinating history. It was first developed in the late 1960s for the Soviet Navy as a military-style diver's watch. It is tough, reliable and capable to reach 200 meters of depth, even with that simple technology. This particular Amphibia has a very utilitary design. A black dial with both 12 and 24 hours markings, large luminous hands, a rotating bezel and a stainless steel case. I will be splitting this restoration into two parts. Part 1 will cover the disassembly and part 2 will be reassemble and hopefully bringing this watch back to life. But before we get started, I would like to thank you for being here. If you enjoy my videos, please consider liking and subscribing. It really helps my channel grow and allows me to keep sharing more watch projects with you. Alright, let's open the case and begin the work. I will start by removing the oscillating weight and then disassemble the self-winding mechanism step by step. Now I'm removing the small spring that holds the two change wheels. The wheels allow bidirectional winding of the rotor. I'm removing the winding bridge. It's held by three screws. The automatic winding system in the Vostok is quite different from Swiss designs. Instead of complex reverse wheel setup, it used two simple intermediate wheels with a spring, which allows the rotor to wind the mainspring in both directions. It's not the most efficient system, but extremely reliable and easy to service. This simple approach is typical of Vostok engineering. I gently lift the bridge. And now I can remove the change wheels. Right wheel. And left wheel. Now the transmission wheel and the clutch wheel. Here in the self-winding mechanism we can see the clutch wheel, which connects directly to the ratchet wheel. Unfortunately, this wheel has a tooth missing. Later on, when I open the barrel bridge, we will actually find the broken tooth inside. Now let's take a closer look under the microscope. I'm removing stem by pressing push button. And the seal, which is in very good condition. Definitely I can reuse it. Now, let's remove the mechanism from the case. Oh, that dial is beautiful. In very good condition. The next step is to remove the hands. I'm using a polyfilm to make sure I will not scratch the dial. And the hands are removed. I will keep them safe. The next step is to remove a ratchet wheel, crown wheel and click. The ratchet wheel is out. I'm removing now the crown wheel. And the click. Before removing the click, it's a good idea to remember its position, so you can fit it back the right way. And now I'm removing the click spring. The next step is to remove the balance wheel. I unscrew balance cog. It's held by one screw. Now I'm removing the spring that holds the second wheel pinion. Oops, and the spring fly away. But I have it. No worries, I have it. Let's remove the barrel bridge. It's held by three screws. If you are still watching, thank you. I really appreciate it. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you are enjoying this restoration. Before I remove the barrel bridge, I need to remove the train bridge and the train wheels. The barrel bridge is one of the main plates that support the gear train. Underneath it sits the main spring barrel, which stores the energy for the entire movement. The design on the Vostok is very robust. Not fancy, but built to last. Now I can remove the barrel bridge. There is a small spring and small wheel under the barrel bridge, and I need to be careful to not lose it. That spring and the bearing allows the crown wheel to float and disengage smoothly when the rotor is driving the ratchet wheel. Now I'm removing the center seconds pinion and the winding and sliding pinion. Here on the main spring barrel you can see the broken tooth. This would cause the gear train to slip or jam, stopping the watch. To remove the dial, I first need to take out the stainless steel movement retaining ring, which is held in place by two screws. Now I will release two tiny screws that holds the dial. And I can gently remove the dial from the movement. Now the dial is off, so I have access to the dial side. I'm removing the parts step by step. First, the tin cover plate over the date and keyless work. Now we can see the date jumper spring and the date jumper itself. We need to be very careful to not lose that part. Now I take off the date wheel. And I can remove the our wheel. The date mechanism in Vostok 2416B is very straightforward. A driving wheel mounted on the hour wheel has a small finger that pushes the date wheel forward one step every 24 hours. The change happens gradually and completes around midnight. To keep the date aligned in the window, a spring-loaded part called the date jumper presses against the teeth of the date wheel. This locks the wheel in position until the next change. It's not an instant change like in some Swiss watches. The Vostok switches more slowly, but the design is simple, durable, and easy to service. Next, I will disassemble the keyless mechanism, starting by removing setting lever spring. I'm using polyfilm to make sure I won't lose any parts. Now I attempt to remove the yoke spring. I couldn't find the spring. It just flew off and vanished. But I will continue with disassembling the remaining part of the watch. I am removing the minute wheel and the intermediate wheel. On the other side, I am removing the pellet fork bridge and the pellet fork. I remove cannon pinion using small pliers, and now I can remove the center wheel. The last thing left is a gear that I can remove using my tweezers. All parts are removed, prepared for cleaning, and now I will focus on the case. I'm removing the bezel with a case opening tool, protected with cloth, and carefully praying against the case to avoid scratches. Crystal requires some polishing, but first I will clean the case. I'm using pegwood and alcohol to clean the main dirt, and later on I will place it in ultrasonic cleaner. I will need to order a replacement for damaged clutch wheel, as well as missing spring. I will order also a new bezel, before I can continue with the repair. To polish the crystal, I'm using a 3000 grit sandpaper to remove the deep scratches, and later on I'm using a diamond paste. That's it for today's work on Vostok Amphibia. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this project, please give it like and subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. See you in the next part.